An air and sea search is continuing for possible survivors of the Edmund Fitzgerald, a 729-foot ore carrier, which apparently broke apart and sunk last night on Lake Superior. The ship and its 29-man crew vanished in a storm with 80-mile-an-hour winds and wave heights up to 25 feet. All that has been found is an oil slick and some debris.
Legend lives on from the Chippewa on down, up the Big Lake they call Good Sugar Man. The lake, it is said, never gives up for dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. But the load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That big ship and true was a bung to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. Later that night when the ship's bell rang, it'd be the north wind they'd been feeling. The wind in the wild made a tattletale sound and a wave broke. Every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. Supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, fellas, it's too rough to feed ya. At 7 p.m. a main hatchway gave in. He said, fellas, it's been good to know ya. The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the big ship and crew was in peril. And later that night when his lights went out of sight, in the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald.
He last had contact with him, and they had talked to him. But about 10 minutes after 7, 1910, and he said he was going along fine and no problem.
But it looks from the information that we have that it's fairly certain that the Fitzgerald went down.
Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn in minutes to hours? The searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay. They put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up, but they might have capsized. They may have broke even tumble water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters.
Lake
Huron rose at the scenes in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan's teams like a young man's dreams, the islands and days of a sportsman. Farther below Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go as the mariners all know with the gales of November. Remember.
a musty old hull in Detroit. They prayed in a maritime sailor's cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa down up the big lake they call Kitchigoomy. Superior, they say, never gives up, redeemed when the gales of northern.